My brothers and sisters, may the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees came forward and began to argue with Jesus, seeking from him a sign from heaven to test him. He sighed from the depth of his spirit and said, "Why does this generation seek a sign? Amen, I say to you, no sign will be given to this generation." Then he left them and got into the boat again and went off to the other shore. The Gospel of the Lord. For a moment, we see in Mark's account today kind of the emotional effect that the failure of the Pharisees to understand what Jesus is doing had upon Jesus himself. It's said in very poetic words, he sighed from the depth of his spirit. And of course, in the process, continues to say to them, why don't you see? Why don't you recognize? Why don't you have the faith, given the fact that you've been given that gift through salvation of being the chosen people? Yet over and over again, they keep trying to seek signs from Jesus to somehow prove. And the irony, of course, is that even when signs are given, more often than not, they and we as well tend to underplay them. We end up saying to ourselves, it's just a trick, it doesn't mean anything. We don't see it because of the logic or lack of reason thereof. And so as a result, even if signs were to come before us, more often than not, we would take or turn the other way. Jesus, of course, bottom line, as we heard in that little phrase in the Alleluia today from John's account, he is the sign. I am the way, he says. I am the truth. I am the light. He is the sign, not the things he does, but who he is. And so as we begin the journey with him in this Lenten season, it's another opportunity for you and for me to come to understand and to know him better and to recognize that it is in him that all is found, not in the words necessarily spoken, not in the healings that take place, but in being connected with him.